Welcome to the theater. My name is Doug. We are going to have some fun today. Here's the thing, though. You guys have a choice. We can do a good show, or we can do kind of like an show. What do you guys want? You're my kind of people. This is good. I don't have to work that hard. Oh, you're going to make me work. You want the good show. All right, well, here's the thing. It's not up to me, all right? It's actually up to you guys because you have a big part in today's show. This is not the kind of show you get to sleep through. Sorry about that. This is the kind of show you actually have to participate in. And these are the cue cards. Now, the brown ones tell the actors what they're supposed to do. And the blue ones, those ones are for you. So let's go through these together, okay? If we amaze you during the show, we hope we show you some things that are amazing. All you have to do is simply make this noise. Everybody try it now.
Wow.
Wow. And if anyone gets scared during today's show, just go, Mom. You can do that too, okay? If anything funny happens in the show, simply repeat this over and over again. Good, good, good. If someone says ta-da, and there will be someone saying ta-da in the show, simply make this noise. Everybody practice clapping. Clapping is good. Good, 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 good. That's the aerobic part of the show, by the way. And if we fool you during the show, if we do anything that fools you, we hope you have some fun and just say, huh? That's kind of like what you're going to do in school this year, isn't it? Yeah. What grade are you going into? Third grade multiplication table time, right? Yeah. You want to do writing instead? Oh, yeah. No, well, when they do the math class, just say, to your teacher a lot because they like hearing that, okay? That's their job, all right? And, of course, this word says finale, and finale is a French word, and it means throw money at us, right? Just toss it up here on stage. I'll tell you all, before we get the show started, people are still coming in. Welcome to the theater. We're going to have some fun. We're going to play a little game. We're going to play tic-tac-toe. Where are my tic-tac-toe experts? Anywhere? Tic-tac-toe experts? So you guys don't even raise your... Of course you're the tic-tac-toe expert. Of course you are. What is your name, by the way?
Finley.
Finley? That's a good name. Hi, Finley. Nice to meet you. Finley, here's the deal. If you're going to play tic-tac-toe with somebody, you always want to go first. That's why I'm going to go first, okay? I'm going to be the browns. You're going to be the blue. Finley, if you ever go first, here's a tip. Always take the middle spot because you've got the most chances to win. You know that, right, Finley? Now, you're blue, and there's another really good spot to take if you're going to go second. It's one of the, do you know? One of the corners, because this way you've got the most chances to win. You can win horizontally, vertically, or you can actually win if you get all four of the corners, which is something people don't really even realize. I'm going to go next, Finley. It's my turn. I'm going to go right here. Now, Finley, your job is to get three in a row. My job is to get three in a row, but you got to stop me, too. So where do you want this one to go? That spot right there? That's the spot right there? Is that what you said? Oh, sorry. I'm sorry, Finley. I couldn't understand for a minute there. Sorry about that. Okay, Finley, it's my turn. I'm going to go right here. Now, be careful. It's going to be your turn, Finley. Where do you want this one to go?
Right there.
Right there by the
funny.
Right there. Right by the funny over here, Finley?
No. I'm sorry.
Why are you being so difficult, Finley? Fine, I'll put it right here, okay? All right, she's good at this game. All right, Finley, it's my turn now. I'm gonna go, I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna go here. Okay, there we go, perfect. Now you get to put the blue one in place. Where's it gonna be? Yeah, I know where you want to go. I'll stop messing with you. And the last one goes right here. Finley, thank you for playing me. And you can see that, I won. So. What? Have you ever played with a three-year-old?
No.
They make up their own rules. I make up my own rules too, okay, Finley? Let me explain, Finley. I use browns and blues instead of X's and O's. You knew that. You figured that out, right? Here's something people don't know, is there's actually 235,000 different ways you can arrange these nine squares. Finley, I had no idea how this game was going to end up. You had no idea how it was going to end up. Here's something else you had no idea about. The back of these cards had this pattern printed on them, which is kind of crazy, especially in the one out of 235,000 different times, it actually comes out and says, standing ovation. Whoa! Thank you. Thank you. Wow, we've got people standing. You guys are going to be awesome. I promise you what, we are going to have a ton of fun today. I have lots of actors backstage that are about to come out. Let me open the curtain. We'll get the show started. Thanks for being here.
Spirits of the wind, we call on you to fill the night with hope and passion.
My name is Miss Lise, and I understand there may be somebody in the audience named Finley. Where would they be? Up in the balcony?
Over here.
Back row?
At the first
row. Oh my gosh! I'm so glad you raised your hand. Hi, Finley. Perfect, because see, we need kind of a security guard today in the show, and they only can be named Finley. So you're perfect. I can't believe this is happening. So this is an envelope, everyone can see it, with a window and a yellow piece of paper. Finley, it's perfect you're in the front, because I'm just gonna magnetize it right there. Just keep your eye on it every once in a while. Make sure no one messes with it during the show. Got it? Good. Oh yeah, she gave me the thumbs up. Well, now it's time for the card trick. Everybody knows in a magic show you have to have a card trick, right? You're expected. It's part of our contractual obligation. All right, so we're gonna do it together, and here's the thing. Every magician knows in a magic show, if you do a trick twice, you can figure it out. The audience usually are on to you. Well, we're gonna throw that rule out. We don't care. We're gonna do it twice so you can figure it out, okay? We're gonna begin with this invisible deck of cards. Does everybody see it?
No, it's invisible.
Good answer, but Finley, squint one eye, squint the other eye, close both eyes. Do you see the deck in your mind's eye? Yes?
I can imagine it.
Yes, you can imagine it. Good, because guess what? I'm going to open them up and you're going to hold the empty box. See? See, it works every time. All right, Finley, I'm going to shake. I'm going to shuffle the cards. Okay, everybody, I'm shuffling the cards. All right. And I'm going to fan them out. And sir, with the Batman shirt, I'm going to have you select a card from this deck, okay? Thank you. Take a peek and memorize it. Okay, you got it. Good. Now I'm going to take... Did you just throw it on the ground? Okay. Just checking. I don't come to your house and throw your toys on the ground. I'm just saying. So I'm going to take this deck and I'm going to turn it so it's face up. I want you to put your card face down in the deck, please. Face down. Good. Very good. And we're shuffling. And now you can tell all of us what your card was.
Ace of clubs.
Ace of clubs. So I'm going to fan the cards out. I'm going to spread them until we get... I don't see it. But there is one card that is face down, and it is the Ace of Clubs! Ta-da! You are so supportive of that fake magic. Thank you very much. All right, I'll take the box back. Thank you. You knew just what to do. Have you been here before? I don't know. But Finley, I'm gonna give this back to you full, okay, this full deck. Thank you. I want you to take those home with you.
Okay.
Okay, good. And is this your brother? All right, well, tonight, when he's asleep, sneak that deck of cards under his pillow, and in the morning, they will have completely vanished.
Cool.
She said, cool. I got you now. I'm so glad. What's that? She will be asleep really fast after this full day. Now let's do the trick again with a real deck of cards. I promised you I would do it a second time. I already forget your card. It was the Ace of Clubs. All right. So I'm going to fan the cards out just like I did down there. And we're going to spread them nice and wide until we do see that there is one card face down. And it is your Ace of Clubs. Ta-da! What do you think?
Good. That was awesome.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Ooh. You did it.
Yeah.
Good job.
They did it.
You have them? Good. You can put those on eBay too, see if you can sell those.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Is Finley in charge of the envelope?
She is security guard.
I have a feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Finley, you know what you're supposed to do, right? If anyone touches the envelope, you jump up and yell emergency, and I'll come out and save the day, okay? Do you want to practice one time? Watch, let's try this.
No! Oh, she's good. Hands off.
I'll take no as emergency. We'll go with that too, all right? Good deal. You like no better? No better is good. That's fine. You can yell that as well. Hey, you know what, Finley? You're like the guardian of the galaxy today. You're like a superhero. Do you like superheroes?
Yeah.
Do you?
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, yeah. I love that movie. I have a favorite superhero, too. His name is Mandrake. He's a magician. He's back from 1934. He was actually the very first comic strip superhero, even before Superman. People don't know about him. He was a magician. He wore a top hat and a cape. He used his magic to defeat the evildoers. And you're about to meet Mandrake right now. Round of applause for Mandrake, everybody. Here he is.
Great magicians do two things. They show you something you have never seen before, and they show you something amazing. Today, I'm going to do just that. I have something inside this bag that I can guarantee that none of you have seen before. And when I say guarantee, I mean it. I will give each and every one of you $1,000 if any one of you have seen this before. Are you ready to see it? Now, I know what you're thinking. I owe everyone $1,000 in this room right now, but I do not. Here is the reason why. Yes, you may have seen this toy before, but you've never seen it arranged in this configuration. How do I know? That is because a single Rubik's Cube has over 43 quintillion configurations. You've never seen this, or this, or this either. I can do this about 43 quintillion times. By the way, 43 quintillion is 43 with 18 zeros after it. Nobody has seen every combination of this puzzle. Here, show me something I've never seen before. Give it a mix. Twist it and mix it as much as you like. You can keep mixing that cube nonstop for the next 1400 trillion years and never see the same configuration twice. Now, here is another crazy fact. Maybe the craziest of them all. No matter how mixed up a cube is, it can fully be solved in 20 moves or less. And when I say less, I mean down to zero moves. And I'm going to solve this cube in about one move. Now, don't forget my job as a magician is to show you something amazing. Get ready. It is done. Take a look. Ta-da! Now, I know what you're thinking. I'm cheating. You think there is another cube in that bag? No, there's not. I shall prove it. Look, nothing falls out. The bag's empty. I'm not holding anything in this hand. Okay, fine. You caught me. There is something inside this bag, but it is something you have seen before. It is another fully solved Rubik's Cube. Now, ain't that amazing?
Whoa! have you noticed a pattern here? The tricks are all kind of crummy, then they get good at the end. Did you see that? That's how we do it around here. That was pretty good too, yeah. How about if we change the pattern though? How about if we start out with the trick that's really good, then gets kind of crummy at the end? Would you like that instead? Kind of a change of pace? You're in one of those moments? Well, you know what? We actually need someone to help us out with this next one. Do you have any idea who might be a volunteer today? Oh, you would. Come here. She's like, what? It's my show. What do you know? Finley, nice to meet you. Finley, you're going to be going in our time machine today. Before, though, we have to do this. I have to ask you a question. Face your friends, big smile on your face, and tell me how old you are.
8.
What?
8.
Oh, Finley, I'm so sorry. It's my mistake. You have to be 9 to do this part of the show. Let's try it again. How old are you?
9.
Finley, come here! Finley, get up on stage right now. You go talk to Miss Lees, and I will see you up there in a couple of seconds, all right?
And I'm going to call you Fearless Finley. Fearless Finley, stand right there on that letter T. That stands for trap door.
Shouldn't it be TV?
Oh, you are good. You just upstaged me. I love it. That's awesome. TD, we'll put a D on that for the next show, all right? Good idea. Hey, just checking. So today in the time machine, you get to go back into the past or ahead into the future. What would you prefer to do?
Back into the past, into the Microraptor time.
Perfect! You're writing our next script. You are awesome. The Microraptor time.
Finley. This is our time machine. Now, I know what you're thinking. It doesn't look like much, right? But we didn't have much of a budget either, so today we're just going to have to deal with this, all right? Now, Miss Lees will tell you exactly what to do, and Dr. G will tell us a little bit about time travel.
Time travel is now possible thanks to the works of H.G. Wells and his book, The Time Machine. This book was written back in 1895, and it helped to usher a whole new genre of storytelling known today as science fiction. And to prove that time travel is real, we are going to use this book. But thanks to the young time traveler, what you're about to see is not going to happen.
Did you hear that? What you're about to see is not going to happen. Now, I know that sounds completely crazy, but let me explain. This is a very short story. It's only about 76 pages. Have you ever read this by any chance? No, neither would I, because there's no pictures anywhere in the book. But I'll tell you what we're going to do. I'm going to thumb through the book like this, and I want you to shout out stop. When you say stop, I'm going to bookmark one of the pages, okay? All right, let me try. you're quick. Ready? Okay. Right there. I'm going to mark it right there. I'm going to leave the book right here for safekeeping, and I'm going to get right back to you, okay? I forgot to give Finley her traveling instructions. Finley, you have a super very important job, okay? You're going to go back in time today, but you're not going back very far. You're only going back about 9 weeks, okay? Yeah, I know. You're going to June 12th at 2:48 p.m., okay? You're traveling to the Barnes & Noble bookstore at the corner of 6 Mile and Haggerty Road, northwest corner, next to the Einstein Bagels. You can't miss it, okay? What I need you to do is run in there at 2:48 p.m. and stop me from buying that book. You'll see me standing in line pulling out my wallet, okay? Run up to me, rip that book out of my hands, run back to your time machine. But first, throw a $10 bill on the counter, and I wish you luck. Finley, do you have any idea what's about to happen? Do you have any questions? No? Let's do it. It's time to go traveling. Here we go.
Wait! Have you forgotten everything? You are forgetting one particular device that will help make this machine work. What we need is the flex capacitor. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, feast your eyes on this!
Sir, you are laughing at our flex capacitor. Do you have a thigh master at home? Let me see your thighs.
Here we go. It's time to send Finley into the past. It's going to happen right here on the count of three. Get ready. $40,000 a year in college. went back in time to do her job. Let's get back to the book. We bookmarked a page in this book. It's time to take a look at the page number you stopped me at. Can you see the page number we stopped on right there? Oh my gosh, sir. Do you put the glasses on? Can you see the page number? Don't say it out loud. Can you see the first word on the page? Yes, excellent. Good deal. I want you to remember that word and don't forget the page number. Buddy, it's your turn. Hold this book in your hands like this, high over your head. Let me tell you what's going to happen. That book is going to disappear while you're holding on to it. It's so cool. The second Finley stops me from buying that book, it's not going to exist in this time or in this place. While we're waiting for that to happen, let me show you something kind of cool. You saw a page number? You thought you saw a page number? You thought you saw a word too, right? Here's what I want you to do. I want you to pretend you're screaming that word at somebody. Don't say anything out loud. Pretend you're yelling it though. I'm gonna see if I can figure out the word. I think I got it. Okay, I can see a picture right now. It starts with the letter G, am I right? There's five letters. What's the word you were thinking of? Glare, like G-L-A-R-E. That's what I thought, and that's kinda cool. He's still holding on to it. Finley, did you go back in time?
Yes.
Did you spend my money?
Yes.
Finley, what did you spend my money on?
Taffy.
Tackies?
Taffy.
Oh, taffy. You bought taffy? Finley, you had one job. You were supposed to stop me from buying that book. Finley, where's my $10 bill? Finley, what is this? Finley, it's a piece of paper. It's a piece of paper with, wait a second, torn from a book. Finley, what page number is that? 46. What page are you thinking of?
40.
What? Dude, open up that book. Open up to page 46. Finley, head back to your seat. You guys, this is crazy. Because Finley did not rip the book out of my hands. Instead, Finley ripped a page out of the book. You got it, buddy. You found page 46. It's been ripped out. And that is a perfect fit. Give Finley a big clap, everybody, for being awesome today. Finley, boom. Nicely done. Crazy. Hey, it's 1895 when this book was first written. Why don't we travel back even further to 1865? 1865 was the end of the Civil War. You know that, right? The thing is, our men, our boys, were not able to do the hard labor that was still required to build America. So we brought in the Chinese immigrants. Chinese immigrants brought with them a snake oil supplement. True, it was rich in omega-3s. It kept them healthy and strong. Well, it wasn't long before a bunch of con men showed up on the scene trying to sell their own snake oil supplement. You're about to meet one of those guys right now. Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Dr. G.
Ladies and jellybeans, boys and squirrels, I've got a question for you and an answer that you'll be tickled to hear. Do you have an ouchie anywhere on your body? Inside or out, in your noggin, nose, or knees? If it is a real ouchie, then just stay home. Just hunker down, have a heaping helping of honey, and handle your hindrance. You don't want anyone else to ail from the ailment that ails you. That'd be bad. But what if it is a phony ouchie? That is an ouchie that you've got, but you don't know that you've got until we tell you that you've got it. Got it? Good. Regardless, I have a solution that you can sip, swig, slather, or swallow. Prepare to purchase my preposterously powerful proprietary potions of plenty prophylactic preparations. That's right. It comes as a juice, antidote, and balm. Call them what you like. These potions will give you motion. They're lotions to give you notions to put springs in your steps and hustles in your bustles. Just sit still for a second. soak up the solution, and say, sayonara, suppose it's just symptoms. Try that. Sayonara. Suppose it's just symptoms. Now watch this. This is a phony ouchie. This is still a phony ouchie. And that is a real ouchie. The best part about this is that this is guaranteed to work. Guaranteed to fill my bank account and empty your wallet. Whoa! Would you look at this? That's a hot offer. And if you're pulling out your hair, trying to decide what's not true or what's false, a rigorous multi-week testing period revealed just a few happy side effects. This magic elixir even grows hair. Ta-da! It's like magic. It's like hope and a prayer. It's one of this business we call science. Of course, this kind of science always works best when you shove your fingers in your ears, close your eyes, and hum. What is this miracle solution called? Well, I'm glad you asked. Because if you're too afraid to get your life back on track, then you need to buy my fibbling, fabulous, and fraudulently effective juiced antidote and balm for real and phony ouchies. Supplies are limited, and time is running out. So while you're digging deep into your wallet, we have some more entertainment for you. Let's get back to the show.
Let's get back to the show. Finley, after the show is over, we're going to send you back in time one more time, okay? You're going back to 1993. You're going to buy me some Apple stock at $9 a share, okay? All right. I wouldn't be here. Watch me vanish. All right. Check it out, everybody. Speaking of winning money, these are ping pong balls. Each one of these balls has a different number written on it. We're going to choose a whole bunch of these. We're going to try and predict the big numbers in the Michigan lottery drawing. Doesn't matter where you're seated, I can reach everybody. Here we go. We're going right over here to this young lady first. Ma'am, do me a favor. Reach inside there, pull out one of those balls, any number you like, and then shout out the number you have chosen. What do you have? No, I can't see. 19? 19?
It's 19.
19. This lady right here, ma'am, do me a favor. Reach inside there and pull one out. What's your number?
10.
10. Excellent. Finley's brother, reach inside there, buddy. Reach inside there and pull one out. Tell us your number. What do you have? Show it to me. Show it to me, dude. 14.
14.
Excellent. I'm jumping all the way over here. Do me a favor. Reach in. So you take one out. Take, okay, Dad's going to take one out. Perfect. What do you have? What's the number? Another four, two 14s. Throw it back in there. Yeah, mix it up. Mix it up. What do you got?
Oh, great.
45.
45.
45. Would you spot one out, please? Thank you so much. And tell me what you have. Seven.
Seven.
We need one more. Well, Finley, of course, you have to pick one as well, right? So grab the last one, Finley. What's it going to be? 49. All right, throw them back in there. Throw them back in there, please. Throw the ball back in there. We're going to collect them all up, please. I'll take yours as well. Toss it back in there. No, sir, we already have one. Thank you so much. Throw yours back in there right over here. And the last one, I believe, is way over there. I should have taken this to church this morning. I could have made a killing with this thing. Reach in there. There it is. Perfect. All right. You know what? Let me see if I can manage this thing. Would you help out? I'll tell you what. I'm going to go around back, okay? I'll give you my microphone.
All right, Finley, security guard Finley, did you make sure that no one touched this throughout the show? Good job. It's time to reveal what's inside. We're going to let Doug do that. But fearless Finley, would you please join me once again on stage here on this platform? Good, good, good. Stand right beside me here. It's right there for you. No one's touching it.
Of paper the entire show, it has not left your sight, correct? There it is. Let's take a look at it.
All right, Finley, go ahead and open it up. I'll hold the microphone. You read those numbers out loud to the audience, nice and slow, one at a time, nice and loud as well. Flip it up. There you go.
19, 10, 14, 45, 7, 49.
Finley, look up there.
Finley, come here. This is crazy. That's unbelievable, the same numbers. Finley, you take this home, you play these numbers next week, and if you guys win, you don't have to worry about school ever again, okay? I know you do. I love school too. Everybody, this is Gannon, my son. This is Miss Lees.
I'm his daughter.
Go to your room, young lady. My name is Doug, and this is Finley, the star of today's show. Finley, take a bow. Take a bow. Come on back at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, and then tomorrow, Finley's back on stage at noon for 4 more shows. So thanks for watching. We're keeping her. Bye, everybody.